Welcome to the seventh week of the course Integration of Photovoltaic Systems in Microgrids. During this week, we will cover the topic of protection in microgrids. In this video, we will introduce the protection layer of the microgrid framework, and we will see what its main role. Additionally, we will have a look at the main protection devices that are used in both power systems and microgrids. We have already seen that a microgrid can be divided into four layers. On the lower layer, we have the physical infrastructure. The second level is occupied by the communication layer, where standards are set to allow data exchange between devices. The top level contains the business models and the regulatory framework. Protection and grounding corresponds to the third layer, which is control and protection. We have already seen that in a centralized approach, a microgrid features a microgrid central controller that is responsible of monitoring and actively making decisions within the network. We also saw that local control is responsible for the physical setting of the power converters, generators, and loads in the microgrid. As we have seen, the main goal of active control is to turn microgrids into flexible, efficient, robust, reliable, and economic power networks. All these requirements cannot be met unless protection is implemented on the third layer together with control mechanisms. This is because the power flows in microgrids are bidirectional, and to allow the expected flexibility and reliability, intelligence should be also part of the protection schemes to allow a fast and adaptive response. Protection devices such as fuses, relays, and circuit breakers are adopted in a protection scheme in order to stop any abnormal working condition detected in the network, including low voltage microgrids. A large number of devices is needed to reduce the impact of faults and to protect equipment, generators, loads, and also humans from dangerous current levels. A fault is in fact defined as an abnormal current level in an electric network. Microgrids need to be properly protected during faults, which can occur either at the external grid or inside the microgrid. Network current can raise due to short circuits in the system. We will learn about different types of faults in the next videos. If a fault occurs at a utility grid, the microgrid should be quickly isolated from the external grid in order to protect the microgrid components like the PV systems and others. This is performed with the operation of protection devices. On the other hand, if the fault occurs inside the microgrid, the protection scheme will aim at isolating the smallest possible area of the distribution feeder. This is intended to reduce the negative impact of the fault on the operation of the microgrid to the minimum. We mentioned that different types of protection devices can be used in low voltage microgrids, namely fuses, relays, and circuit breakers. A fuse is a protective device that interrupts a circuit when an overcurrent occurs. The fuse is a one-time device, which means that it should be replaced every time it serves its purpose. A fuse interrupts the current flow if there is a short circuit. The filament inside the fuse melts when there is an overcurrent, and this is a way for the circuit to be isolated. In the picture, you can see different types of fuses. From the left to the right, you will find a fuse with simple glass housing, one filled with sand and another with ceramic housing. Different housing materials and fillings are necessary to increase resistance to overcurrents. For example, ceramic fuses have generally higher current ratings compared to the ones with glass housing. At household level, fuses are stored in the fuse box. A circuit breaker is an automatic electromechanical switch that protects the circuit from overcurrent. When a fault is observed in the circuit, the switch opens and the current flow gets interrupted. Unlike the fuse, the circuit breaker can be reset after it has been triggered for a further operation. This can be done in a manual or in an automatic way. Protection relays can be either electromechanical or electronic microprocessor based. Nowadays, electronic relays are widely used thanks to their many advantages. An electronic protection relay is a device that receives inputs such as current, voltage, resistance, or temperature, and compares them to set points in order to provide outputs like control warnings, alarms, or turning power on or off. A relay can be used to trip a circuit breaker when a fault is detected. Relays play a very important role in microgrids because they allow flexibility as they have adjustable settings. So let's summarize this lecture. In this video, we have introduced the main role of protection, which is to stop any abnormal working condition detected in the network, to reduce the impact of faults, and to protect equipment, generators, loads, and humans from dangerous current levels. Additionally, we looked at the main protection devices that are used both in power systems and microgrids, which are fuses, circuit breakers, and relays. See you in the next lecture to learn more about protection.